Chapter 11. Who Knows? The police cleaned out the plant, returning everything to normal. Any production of the fear fog was stopped, and any special effect fog at haunted houses was being replaced. No Name was caught for good and placed into the hands of Sheriff Pepper.
Yeah, boy, you keep that mask on. I ain't seen nothing as ugly as you since that elephant tried to pick my pocket. Yup, you know they do that.
A couple cars then drove off, and Alex brought everyone back. Alex had mentioned that he was going to a Halloween party at Keene State College, and could get them all in, since he went there and was a valued supporter. Given everything they had gone through, they all said that they would come. That night, the campus was aglow, with orange lights and blinking faces of jack-o'-lanterns. Bond and Double S Lady entered the party, with Double S Lady wearing a Austrian outfit, and Bond wearing a tuxedo. Now this is how New Hampshire should handle Halloween. No creepy ceremonies, no somewhat possessed people, just good fun. However, why are you still wearing that getup? What are you going for this time?
I thought I would dress like a Hollywood star. I'm Roger Moore.
Oh, brother. As they looked around, Bond noticed Melissa in a bartender uniform, to which Double S Lady laughed at and approached her. She asked where Bond was, and Double S Lady looked around, and then pointed to Bond at a fortune teller's table. She started to walk towards him.
I see a future between you and a female, the teller said.
And do you know who this female might be?
It all depends on the cards and the game you play, whether that be poker, gin, or...
The teller then stopped and drew a card, flipping it to show a man and a woman with the word lovers underneath.
What are you doing, James? Melissa said, approaching.
Nothing, darling. Just getting to know a new way to play solitaire.
Won't you join me in the party? Melissa said.
Bond raised an eyebrow and smiled.
Shall we continue on with this lesson some other time? Perhaps a third lesson?
The teller smiled and nodded. Bond and Melissa then left the teller, and the teller shuffled her cards.
Lock the door as well on your way up, would you, James?
Double S Lady then was walking around until he was jumped on the shoulders by Taylor in a Wonder Woman outfit.
Well, I can see where you got that love for the sword, then. What can I say? Guilty as charged.
Bond and Melissa then joined them, and the lights flickered for a minute and then went out.
A faint sound was heard, as if someone was laughing.
James, was that you? Double S Lady said.
No, I thought that was you.
You don't think, Taylor said.
That's absurd, Double S Lady said.
I wouldn't say that, Daniel. Remember what his title is.
Who knows? Melissa questioned. All four looked at each other and then looked around them at the darkness.
Now what? Melissa said.
Well, why don't I be your knight in the night?
Melissa smiled at Bond's comment, and then Double S Lady felt a slight shake next to him, and it turned out to be Taylor.
Why, Taylor? Afraid of the dark, are we?
She looked at him.
I won't be, she said, embracing the spy.
He and Bond looked at each other, and they all looked outside to see a full moon rising. The party continued throughout the evening. Throughout the quiet campus, however, the sound of a faint laugh traveled, as a figure ran from one of the outdoor fuse boxes.
Ha 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 ha